Can I put this over here? Thank you.
Thank you. We're appreciate you to talk to this matter. First of all, I want to apologize that I misread or perhaps I read a older version of this agenda item, and it was related to a very old presentation. So I want to apologize. I admit it when I'm wrong. So I am wrong. So I want to say yes, sorry. There is a presentation. There is an update. So I'm very happy. I'm very happy that finally Mr. Graham Lee has taken the time to address my concerns, and looking forward to help. I'm not just here to create problems. I'm a tenant leader. I'm not on payroll. I don't receive any stipend, but I want to see this plan to take off. I'm glad that you have chosen 220 Oak Street as the pilot project. Because I mean, knocking on this door forever. So I am happy to see the plan that is laid up for 2019 as part of the Renewal Capital Plan. I have some advices to provide to you. In parallel to that, can we have something in this building as to showcase what we're doing at 220 Oak Street? I'm sure members of the media will be heavily interested. What are we doing there? If we have something, a small version up here out in our building. One of the things I want to say is if someone from this, a member of this board committee can make a motion, so instead of receiving for information, so action can happen at the next board level. In relation to the storage space, I had to say that it's true that they may cut a few spaces, but I see the menu, there are a lot of empty spaces on parking levels. And I would like to encourage Graham, if you can put me on the list of people who are working together to board this pilot project, because I'm aware of the area. So I also want to let you know that COTA and the Salvation Army are looking at being partners in enhancing their services. So parallel to what's planning, is being planned for the common areas, I would like to encourage that we have a discussion moving forward with the Salvation Army and OTA who are willing participants in this enhancing program for mental health and addictions at 220 Oak Street, which I really thank you for that. Thank you, Graham, and thank you. And sorry again if I burst my in a reaction that, oh no, again, we're gonna have another federal update, but right now we have something in writing, and I'm very happy. Thank you. Thank you. And Amanda, it's good to see you, by the way.
Hi. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you, and I think I might have done deputation if it wasn't that challenge. So, this has been on the agenda since I started, so thank you. We do have a pilot going forward. Is there any questions in terms of the report that was put forward? When would we get a report back on that? I think it's in the report, but
It would be contingent on when we actually, so this essentially becomes, I have to acknowledge Sheila Penny, who's actually the one that committed to doing this pilot. When we discussed it, it was actually her that said that this would be the most useful approach. So she's embedding this in a significant amount of other capital work that will be going on at 220 Oak. So I think once we have the finalized schedule for that capital work, we can update the board on the timing at that point. But we know it'll be in 2019.
Great, thank you. Any other questions from anyone? So we'll accept this for information at this point, and for a report back when it comes off of the action items that we haven't attended to.
Don't worry, I'll find that.
Yeah, thank you, that's great. Update on the CSU initiatives is the next item. Oh, I didn't get